Hey folks, this is Gabe with Security Brand, and another day, another account online, another password. How can we keep it all straight? Well, we may have found the solution with our review of Keeper Password Manager. In today's review of Keeper Password Manager, I'm gonna go over the pros and cons, feature set, subscription options, customer support, and applications so you have all the information you need to make the right decision. If you'd like to see a list of our favorite password managers, Google Security Baron Best Password Managers. If you have a question about today's review, leave us a comment and I'll get back to you. Let's start today's review of Keeper Password Manager going over the pros and cons, beginning with the pros. Now you have the option for dark web scan, you have multi-factor authentication and security breach alerts. Now on the con side, you have to pay extra for the dark web scan. You cannot change multiple passwords at once and there's no inbox scan. Now that we've gone over the pros and cons for Keeper Password Manager, let's talk about its feature set, beginning with this main feature, password storage. It can hold unlimited passwords across multiple devices because you make your master password and boom, you're into every account that you have. On top of that, it can even fill out forms. So with the master password, you can add two-factor and multi-factor authentication with the fingerprint ID or face ID with iPhones or Androids. Now, one thing to note is that if you have a browser like Chrome or Firefox or Opera, you can actually import those passwords directly into this password storage manager. Now, Keeper also comes with a password generator, which helps you to create new super strong passwords. It'll also give you a password strength report, letting you know which of your old passwords are weak and may need to be changed. Now, of course, you have to change each of those passwords individually, so that could be a bit tedious. Now, when it comes to security with Keeper Password Manager, know that you're protected with the industry standard for password encryption and password cracking, so you can know and be rest assured that your information is safe. Of course, sometimes you can be a little bit too safe even from yourself and you may forget your password, and fortunately you can give another person access with the emergency contact feature. You can even use the Keeper app itself to securely share your password with whoever you need to, and if there are any security breaches, you will be alerted. When it comes to storage with Keeper Password Manager, you can store all of your information and passwords locally or in the cloud, choosing between 10, 20, and 50 gigabytes. And a nice little extra feature is the dark web scan called Breach Watch. And Breach Watch will scan the dark web, you know, that hotbed of illicit activity for your passwords and accounts, and alert you ASAP if your credentials are found so that you can change those passwords. All right, let's jump into the subscription options for Keeper Password Manager. Now, as an individual, you're gonna pay $29.99 a year, and that will give you unlimited password storage. But I do wanna note that this will not give you the Breach Watch, which is the dark web scan, nor will it give you secure file storage. Those are separate add-ons that you need to pay for on top of the $29.99 a year. Now, if you'd like a family plan, you can get 5 private vaults along with 10 gigabytes of secure file storage for $59.99 a year. Of course, that family plan also comes with everything that you get with your individual plan. Keeper also offers business and enterprise plans. Now, for the business consumers, it's gonna cost $30 per user per year. And for the enterprise consumer, it's gonna cost $45 per year per user. Now, if you'd like to check out a full breakdown of these subscription policies, check out our full review at securitybaron.com. Let's check out the customer support with Keeper Password Manager. Now, it has an online help center, and if you don't find what you need there, you can fill out a form. But where they really have a killer feature with customer support is their 24/7 live chat. We found it to be extremely helpful and super quick in our case. So helpful, in fact, that we actually didn't even call the consumer support number that they actually provide. So they really have more going for them than other password managers out there on the market today. So to counter that, we wanted to make sure we saw what other people were thinking on the internet. Now with Amazon, Keeper has a 4.1 out of 5-star rating, and of the 7 reviews that mentioned customer support, 5 were positive, so about 70%. Now with Google, it doesn't fare as well. It has 3 out of 5 stars and just 2 reviews mentioning customer support, 1 positive and 1 negative. However, coupling our experience with the general reviews that we saw online, we're willing to wager that you're gonna have a positive experience with Keeper Password Manager's customer support. All right, hold on, whoa, whoa. Quick break. I hope you're enjoying our review of Keeper Password Manager. If you want to be kept up to date on the newest in password managers, VPNs, and smart home security, subscribe to our channel. We're dropping new content weekly. All right, let's get back to the video. Let's check out the applications for Keeper Password Manager. Now, there are multiple ways to interface with Keeper, be it on your Mac, Linux, or Windows as a native application, or through the multiple browser extensions available, or even on your mobile device, considering it has a 4.2 out of 5 stars in the Google Play Store and a 4.9 out of 5 stars in the Apple App Store. So you definitely do not lack for ways to interface with Keeper. Now today, I'm gonna check it out on my Windows computer in the web interface and on my iPhone 10. Here I am checking out Keeper Password Manager on my Windows computer. So you'll note on the web interface, the first page is My Vault. So now if I were to look, you can create new elements, you can search your vault, you've got your various secure add-ons and your records. It's a pretty expansive application. Now if I go to check out Identity and Payments, you got your personal information you can fill out here, your phone number, address, and you can put in your payment cards. So, you know, I've put in 1 debit card for the purposes of illustrating. You can see that if I were to tap on here, it would bring up various elements of my card and my name, things like that. Now, other elements that you can get, of course, are the security audit. The security audit is great because, look, it tells me here that I need better passwords, basically. It only gives me a 67% fair, saying that a lot of my passwords are reused, 3 are weak. They're just generally not that strong. Now, we opted to not pay extra for Breach Watch, but Breach Watch would allow you to, of course, go and scan the dark web for your credentials. Below that on the left, you'll see deleted items, which will just put all the things that you deleted from your vault. So those are some of the options you get for looking at all of your records in the Keeper web interface. Here I am checking out the mobile application for Keeper Password Manager on my iPhone 10. Now, if you note, I'm in all records, encryption is on, and we are just buzzing. We are in the vault. You'll see all the different accounts that I have set up, these various Google accounts, ShareCell, just a host of different accounts all set up right here in the mobile application. Now, if I wanted to add a file or record, I'd tap on this plus. In the middle is the plus, it's surrounded by yellow. Create new record, create new folder. To the right of that, you'll see account. Here you have various elements of my account with Keeper and settings. In the settings, you'll see enable self-destruct, which means that after 5 failed login attempts, all your locally stored Keeper files would be erased. There's just a host of settings right here, like Keeper Fill, which allows you to fill out all of your forms, which is pretty useful actually. And you can even set up a default browser like Safari. Now, if I go back to the vault, in the top left-hand corner, you can click and go to your Keeper account, your favorites, your shared, your files, see what's been deleted, and even look into your identity and payments. So if you decided to throw in your personal information or various payment cards, or even do a security audit, which will tell you the same thing that it'll tell you in the web application, which is basically that your security score is not that great and you probably need to create new, stronger passwords. So I'm really excited about the fact that the mobile application does give you almost all the same options that one can find in the web application. And that's me checking out the Keeper Password Manager on my iPhone 10. All right, we've reached the end of our review of Keeper Password Manager, and you want to know, will it work for me? And I'll say this, even at its most affordable price, it provides enough features to be a solid option for password manager. It has unlimited password storage. On top of that, it has really solid customer support and a smooth, intuitive application experience, be it on your desktop or on mobile. Now, if you're someone who doesn't want to pay more for features like the dark web scan or secure file storage, then you may want to look at some of the competitors out on the market that provide that as a part of the general password managing package. But in terms of what is on offer from Keeper Password Manager, I think it is a solid choice for a password manager. So that concludes our review of Keeper Password Manager. If you appreciated today's video, give us a like and hit that subscribe button. As always, this is Gabe at Security Baron. Be secure.